Hi and welcome to today's video, where we're going to machine another part using SolidWorks and SolidCAM. As you can see, to start off with, I want to see what the machining preview is going to be, and we don't have our fixture in at the moment, so we can quickly add our lang vise in ready so we can get going and machining this part. The next step is to go and make sure we've got all the tools we'll need for this as well. And Amugi Franken have been great by supplying us holders and tooling so we can get this job done really simply and really quickly. As you can see in the toolkit, I've previewed everything that I might use today. To start our machining off, we're going to use 3D iMachining, and you can see I've already got this programmed up. Let's go and see what I've done. The 3D iMachining is great for getting a 3D roughed shape out of a billeted material. Go and pick a tool, get its starting position if need be, pick an upper and a lower level that I want to machine to, and then the iMachining wizard allows me to set feed speeds, the step down, all within parameters that will be safe for operation and give us maximum material removal. On the toolpath created, we can see we have one large step down that goes round and takes out all the material it can using a morphing spiral strategy. From there, it then step up machines at an increment that we've decided to get the rest of the rest geometry and get it out machined as quick as possible. To preview this, we can use the SolidCAM simulator, which is a great way to see exactly how the toolpath is going to operate whilst on the machine and give a great representation of the material that's going to be cut. We can even check how much material is left over afterwards if that's what we want to do. But that's only half the story. The next bit after we've simulated it is looking what it will do on the machine itself. So as you can see, as we come through to the machining, we can see how the iMachining is cutting at a 1-to-1 speed, just so you can see how much material can be removed at a really large depth and really fast speed. This view from the machine really shows how quickly and effortlessly the material gets removed and how constant the chip thickness is as we go around and use the iMachining toolpath. Our SolidCAM is altering feeds and speeds and cutter engagement angle to make sure that we're getting a constant chip thickness and a constant tool load. It makes sure that we minimise the tool wear, even on these really deep and aggressive cuts. Coming to the centre section, we can really see the step-up machining in action. After we've gone and hit everything we can do at that base level, we come in at small increments up as a step-up value while still taking lots of material away and keeping a constant chip thickness, making sure we're getting rid of the material as quick as possible. Got a core of material out, we can do other operations as well. So in this case, we're using HSR's rest roughing option to make sure that we've got as minimal stock left before we go into our finishing operations. You can see I've created a boundary to work within. I can then tell it what potential tool I've used or the remaining stock I've left on. And from there, SolidCAM will calculate where I need to go if we're giving you a highly efficient toolpath, only getting the areas we want with no air cutting whatsoever. And as you can see here in the simulation again, hitting those places that may have been somewhat left from the high step up that we'd left previously, giving us a really good place to start finishing off. Again, the simulator gives us a really good idea of what's going to happen, but when we look back on the machine, we can see we're getting exactly what we were expecting as the tool goes up and down in the areas that we wanted to machine. And as we go and move through this further, we can see it's going to go and hit the walls and the dome shape in the middle as well. Now we've completed the roughing on this first side, let's look at finishing machining. So HSM has a comprehensive tool set for 3D finishing applications. And to start off with, you're going to use linear machining. This puts a tool path straight over in linear passes up and down the part. And in this case, we've done it to 45 degrees to make sure we don't leave any unwanted geometries. And you can see there we get a high level of cleanup on that first pass. And again, as we've shown before, this is reflected in a good surface finish to start us off on the machine itself as it goes and scans backward and forward. SolidCAM, however, is much more capable than just 3-axis toolpaths, and in this channel here we want to use a simultaneous 5-axis toolpath. Because of the shape of it, we only need to engage 4, but you can see I'm going to morph between two curves that I've chosen, hitting the surfaces that I want to hit and making sure that I don't gouge on the tool or the holder, even with a complex geometry. What this allows us to do is get a really nice smooth toolpath to make sure that that face, our faces, are consistent and exactly what the customer wants. Since the SolidCAM simulator can spot and stop if there's any gouges, this gives us great confidence when we move onto the machine in a complex motion that we're not going to have any problems whatsoever. And as you can see, the tool is moving exactly as we expected, nice and smoothly around the part. Wouldn't be right to stop there though, so let's go and see how we went on and finished off this part. You can see, as we've moved into setup 2, we've made fixturing to clamp into our lang vise, and this could have been replicated in SolidCAM. And you can see as the toolpath goes round, again we're getting that constant chip thickness to take away material as quick as possible. And in the 3D iMachining, finishing off making that reverse shape that we need to make the part correctly, making sure we get it right and fast first time. Sometimes jobs may not have exactly a depth to cut at like here, but again, with SolidCAM iMachining, that isn't a problem. You can see it makes short work of reducing that material to the shape we need, and then it can go and continue on to the parts that we may have not hit previously without any fuss whatsoever. Just like how we had it in the previous operation for roughing, you can see as we finish off, we're going to clear up bottom pass with any 3D geometry that we may have missed to make sure that we're going to get the exact copy for when we start finishing. In the outer, we've used a slightly different toolpath. This is called HSM Constant Z. And what this does is just go and find any Z level depth and then cut at that point. And then we could again finish with any remnant areas that we may have with a constant step over or a linear pass or even some of the simultaneous 5-axis functions. As we finish off, you can see the parts have come out great, making sure that SolidCAM and SolidWorks are working great once again. So until next time, goodbye.